Hello, I'm Tome Keeper Devon, and you're watching RenTech Riders. Before we get into the action, I just wanted to do a quick thank you to our sponsors of Norse Foundry for these lovely dice trays and the dice that we'll be using, as well as Hero Forge for the character portraits, Japanime Games, of course, for the Animaria, and Lynn Vander for the game design. Enjoy the show. Welcome back to RenTech Riders. Our RenTech Riders are currently engaged in combating with a copper dragon and its winged kobold minions into varying degrees of success. One of them is on fire and full of smoke. Another one is on the dragon. And the other two are here too, I guess.
Thanks for noticing.
My favorite Eeyore quote.
We are jumping back to the top of the round,
yes,
with a sawed-off shogun who is dangling off the side of the copper dragon and has discovered that there is a glowing green metal needle of some kind jammed, yes, up into its hide beneath its scales that it's been trying to scratch at but has been unsuccessful, in blood and acid everywhere.
Yeah, so I'm assuming because it is sort of scratching at it, is this like pulling motion like forward and back as opposed to like yanking out a specific like needle.
So it's like if you got
a little tiny sliver
in an air in like between, right, shoulder blades.
Yeah, oh, scratch.
God, like, you can't get rid of it.
You can't pinch it out. You're just...
So I've got a bit of a plan here, but I you did mention I have advantage because perhaps,
yes,
right?
Check some things you make to try and stay stable on the dragon, as well as to do things you will have advantage on, since it is more or less immobilized by the grapple that is currently being undergone from Takiri.
Amazing. So I, the sort of shogun killer, would like to, I've eyeballed this thing. I have protection from acid on. I'm assuming this is not acid, but it's just...
There is acid in the blood that is,
right,
kind of around. So
I don't know what this glowing green, I'm assuming uranium color is.
Yeah, that's about accurate, yeah.
But I'm going to try to use my tinkerer's tools, so I don't have to touch it directly to try to pull
it out. One of those beaker holders come out?
Yeah.
You get like some tongs and...
They're tinker tongs.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Those are tinker tongs.
It's one of those like picker grabber thingies.
Yeah,
like,
you know what? Yeah. Yes. I remember from my time visiting a museum, a dinosaur-headed little grabber.
Wow.
So I'm going to try to pull that out.
Okay, I'm going to give you inspiration.
Yay!
Because yes, the dinosaur head little grabber, that's...
Don't feel me like that.
That is perfect.
And you make it talk to you?
I won't.
Tell you what, I'll do one further. Let's add that to the resolve pool.
I was wondering if I had a way, like, oh, talks, let's maybe it's a friend.
What are we at now, folks?
Three
friendships. All right, great. So for sleight of hand, that is a 16 plus 4.
Pale.
Okay.
Dirty 20.
So yeah, again, so you, you take your little grabber and you just, you get a good grip out. There's like and you carefully just, with like surgical precision, just... And that's what you like... see. This is how much you saw. Oh. This is how much it was.
I was assuming it.
Yeah, yeah.
I have a flashback to when I was a child, seeing like a stone in my like family's temple, and I was like the first one to remove the shotgun from the stone. making me inherit the title of sawed-off shogun.
Wow.
So yeah, it's like, oh, I get this now.
I just thought that's how you removed it. Everyone's like trying to remove it from the stone, and you just took a saw, and you're like, I don't know what the big deal is.
Oh my god, that's what really happened. So the rest of the society maintained composure. They just put a little stone over top to hide the. And they said that he had pulled the shotgun from the stone.
You know what? That's when they say I passed the test of my family, and it shows like my great 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 grandpappy, where he's got a shotgun that's like a 10 meters long, and it's like everybody's figured it out.
So when you cut the stone in half, and you just see all the rings of the shotgun pieces that were left of the generations.
That's how it's come you can tell the age.
This is becoming canon now. So yeah. Everyone, this will be in the Animarium.
No, it's going to still be a shotgun, not a cannon.
That's
for later.
The upgrade.
Thank you. So I've got this out. I'm assuming I don't just want to drop it to the ground since it was causing havoc.
So I will say, as you do remove it, you see like these green and black a wound festering and like little the veins of the hide where there are no scales kind of pulse and bulge as you remove it, and once again there's the roar and the whole dragon shakes. But almost immediately you see the wound kind of start to dissipate and look much healthier than it was before.
Okay, so it doesn't necessarily need immediate attention from what I can tell.
I mean, this is a dragon, right? and this thing is essentially like a little tiny epidermic needle. So to a dragon, it's a thorn in the side, but this apparently was really painful.
Okay, great. So now that I've held on to this and pulled this out, again, I'm assuming it's glowing and green. I'm probably gonna want to hold on to it and not, you know, because I'm not shooting anything right now. Maybe I can like store it in like the barrel of my gun.
Sure.
It's like, cool. And just like hold it on my back. And I'm going to look around and see if there's any other woundy areas.
Yeah. So you're kind of hanging just below one of its wings, right? Kind of where the membrane extends out from the body.
The wing membrane.
Yes. And you can see there is another one over down by its hind leg. And based on what you would know, there's repeats on the other side as well. So I would say you could probably use an object interaction for the first one. Mm-hmm. You could spend an action to remove the second one if you make it over there.
Okay.
To get to it.
Look out, Dragon Heine. It's my time to shiny. And I shimmy on over with my 35-foot climbing speed.
Yes.
And I try to once again use my action
Sounds
to
good.
Remove it. But no Tinker's Tools this time, I guess, because you said I can't use an object again?
No, so you can.
Okay.
You get a free object interaction on your turn, and if you want to do it again, it costs your action.
Okay,
so you're basically action. Doing two object interactions on your turn.
All right. Great. that is a 10 plus 4. Do I still have the inspiration?
You do have advantage from the grapple, so you may as well do a second roll there.
I can't see you, but I got you.
Oh, that is literally on a diagonal. I'm sorry.
Angry bro, that's fine.
13 plus 4, so that's 17.
That's better.
Right,
I was gonna say, it's a little less clean, and then you kind of like, if you're playing Operation, you hit the sides a couple times. There's a bit of like, you're like, I'm like,
as it moves, you're like, oh no! The red light's going off. You're like,
it's like an actual patient screaming, like, ah! And I'm like, fool, lights don't scare me.
and a little bit of acid does pour out, so I will get you to make a dex save.
I do have a protection of acid from acid.
Yes, that's okay. Resistance. So if you do get hit, it'll be barely anything.
Dex save. You
six save.
That for me is a plus 9, so 18 plus 9, 27.
Okay, so you just managed to move in a little bit, kind of just against your arm, which is gonna deal like 10 acid damage, half to 5.
Nice. As
your resistance, so it's barely anything.
A little ouchy.
Yeah.
Small one.
As cool. The magic kind of protects from you from the majority of the damage, but you have now. I mean, the wound looks a little worse than the first one, but you have removed yet another one of these long.
I didn't get in my gun barrel.
Yeah.
You got lots of room in there.
It's for later. Yeah. Okay, cool. And I'm assuming that's all I can do on my.
On your next turn, you can work. You can maybe like get like halfway across the back of the dragon so that you can kind of like on your next turn move your way down. And
as a free action, I'd like to give a little to the wound to see because it can't hurt.
Sure. I mean, you say that.
It might hurt.
Well, right. Acid. Chef lifts.
Like, no.
One layer of skin on your lips.
God. Verderar bacteria. That's you. Verderar. It's the only thing.
The Verderar just got Verderar.
Oh, no.
Sorry.
It's like a familiar dragon. You just killed the dragon.
Yeah.
Oh, you're poison.
I don't know.
Saliva, yeah.
I don't know.
It's actually worse than it was before.
Yeah.
The three kobolds that are left and currently on Shogun's Rentec, which is stationary, are going to just keep trying to do stuff to it. Let's see. That's going to be a 18, which I don't think is enough.
No.
And lower than that. So they're just unable. So they're like scurrying around trying to find more things, but I mean. Rentec,
I can do that too.
It's so shoddy already. They don't know what.
Yeah, they're shoddy. They can't tell the difference between like a part and like just nonsense because it's all like kind of hastily hodgepodge together. So.
Well, motion.
Oh yeah.
So he's. You have, which one did you have? Which model do you have?
The BFS.
BFS has no difference. It's heavily armored. It's a heavily armored Rentec.
Oh, but I modded it to be large bacon.
Who can't see?
So,
guys,
that's
wrestling
out
like.
Yes, the tail will once again come up to try and smack at you.
I've had worse.
But you're gonna get hit again. So 15 bludgeoning damage into the Rentec.
Not the good.
That'll bring us to Eke.
No, forgive me because it's been a whole episode. The last thing I did was the split seconds lightning bolts, right?
Mm-hmm.
So my action economy then is reduced. So I have action or bonus action. I cannot do both.
Mm-hmm.
I will. Seeing. Okay, so what am I seeing now? Am I seeing him pull Rennick steel out?
I don't know. What's your passive perception?
Oh.
13.
I get it.
I don't think you're seeing exactly what he's doing. You can see Shogun up on the dragon. You see he's like doing some kind of impromptu surgery of some sort.
But no, like lights.
But you can't. Yeah, you can't really make out what exactly is happening because this is also while the dragon is being grappled by another Rentec, which is having smoke billowing out of it and fire. Like, you know, there's a lot going on.
But basically, he's not stabbing it or killing it. He's doing something to it.
It looks like whatever he's doing is causing like some pain to the dragon, but it is not like damaging the dragon.
Okay, I've only got one of the two actions anyhow. Let's see what spell. Hold on. Where did it go?
There it is.
It is one action.
Oh,
that's one action. And I see this mech about to get bamboozled.
I'm not doing too hot. I mean, I'm really hot at
it. See, billowing smoke.
I think I'm about to explode.
Billowing smoke and fire, pieces of it are falling away.
It's yelling at me.
Yeah, the magic mouth spell is continually yelling at you about all the different problems that are going on.
Shut up!
Actually, out of curiosity for the way Rentecs work, are we attuned to it for ourselves, or could someone else hop on your Rentec?
Theoretically, anyone could pilot them if they know what to do.
Hi. He needs help. I need these kobolds off my mech.
Understood.
I don't know what he's doing. That would be metagaming if I cast haste on him to help him go.
Presumably. I mean, you know he's doing something. Yeah.
I won't do that. I think I need to get knowledge on what's going on, but Eke won't leave. As long as they're still standing, Eke won't leave his mech while those little gremlins are sleeping, knowing what they're doing to the other mechs, because he can't deal with these guys. So what he will do is, as an action, he will cast message.
Okay.
And he will say, what did you find? You are able to respond.
I'm able to respond.
You can respond with a single sentence.
As long as it's a full, complete sentence.
Not a run-on.
Well, no,
you get like you get two comments.
Yeah, I was gonna say, yeah, you get like
one sentence a day.
One, hear it in your head. What did you find?
One reasonably grammatical sentence.
Within the wounds of the dragon, I found a single long green rod, comma. And when I looked beyond that, I found more wounds on the dragon, which seemed to create more green rods.
It does have a 25 word.
Which I've taken.
Yeah, I think
it's 25 words.
I think we got the gist of it.
Okay, that was good. Comma. And then, so I can't cast, I can't respond again. That was my trip
right.
cast.
Yes.
And that is my action, because I've borrowed too much time. So
yep. I think that's fair.
I am complete.
So you have been told that, but no one else yet is aware of what Shogun is doing. You have not, not had a way to waylay this yet. It is now the dragon's full-on turn. Would you please roll me? Because I don't responsible for this.
Roll a one, B.
There we go.
Not a one.
That's the breath.
While being grappled, it opens its jaws and acid spews forth. Can I please get your rent? Well, you automatically failed dex saves, I think, because your steering is locked.
Yep.
So your Rentek takes 54 acid damage.
My
Rentek
is no more.
How much damage? 54.
Bye, Rentek.
Does it disintegrate?
So
I was at 15.
So the entire front half of your Rentek dissolves away, leaving you open to the elements as its engine sputters and dies. The whole thing begins to crumble away. It's not immediately falling, but it is going to be. On the bright side, you can see the smoke billows out into the open air.
Right? Some
Yeah. Okay. And you're not on fire anymore. But the thing grappling the dragon is falling apart.
It's not on the ground, though, right?
They're like above. They're not like above the open air. They are above.
Right. I feel so much less cool. I thought that I was doing this in the sky. Like
you are.
Oh, we are in the sky.
But I'm on the dragon.
Yes, they are. They are in the sky.
Over a landmass.
You're over a floating landmass, not nothing.
Okay. For a second, I was
so like, if the Rentek falls, it will fall like 100 feet
and onto an island,
which you could potentially survive.
I am monkey.
Versus
like the backdrop behind
falling to the surface, where you are dead.
Yeah. I do just want to remind you that there is just a floating, 100% fine Rentek that is, you know, pretty attuned to you right there. I guess that's metagaming for it.
No, it's fairly obvious. You can see the unpiloted Rentek right there in front
just
of the
dragon. Just like empty aluminum. Dun, dun. Like for the knock on my skull. I figure it out eventually. Do I get like whoosh, by the acid as well, or just the?
Just the Rentek. Okay. The Rentek took all the brunt of the blow.
Brother, I can see you. Speak louder.
The fire and smoke billow out. Nothing. There's nothing left beyond fire. The smoke has now an escape to leave. So for the most part, you're good to go. It is the end of the dragon's turn. Anything you would like to do? Do you have any actions or whatever that you have not spent since your last turn?
Yeah, because you're in time dilation.
I don't have to reactivate.
No, it's always on.
It's always on.
In slow mo, it's breaking apart.
I could have done something else. Motherfucker. I'm just a little bummed. That makes sense.
Played your character. You're good.
Flynn!
Flynn's turn is next, so if you need Flynn to do some kind of assist with something.
Arcuda! There's someone I broke. My mech isn't working anymore.
Hello? Does that mean the comms are gone too?
Hello?
Yes, yeah. They have no way to communicate to people.
Hello? It's unbuckle. I'm gonna unbuckle. Is this tech, like, run tech right in front of me?
His?
Yeah.
It's pretty damn close. It's pretty close. You
can be careful.
I'd say you could probably jump to it. You might have the step of the wind that.
What? She's an aerial elf.
Oh, that's true. You can.
She's a flying elf.
I am an aerial.
Like, you don't have to jump it. You just go. Whoosh.
It's a little.
Don't listen to me. I don't lie. I'm talking.
Here's what he does. He perches himself on the edge of the red ticket. I'm not fucking. Rears back. And he jumps up. And he like. Flies into the air and his wings start flapping. Oh my god, bring him! I'm gonna go into the
rental. Cool. You spend your move action in time dilation to move outside your turn to sail over to the Rentek and get in. Now, on your turn, you'll kick in and you'll be able to use.
Well done.
Flynn! What would you. So you now have seen. That Takiri's Rentek is no more. Yeah. A big giant red X shows up in the illusion display system.
Oh.
But you do hear their voice coming over from Shogun's.
Oh yeah, and my ship broke. I'm in Kyoto's thing.
Okay, because where is the sawed-off shogun?
Or the dragon.
Aboard the dragon? Like, atop of the dragon? In the dragon?
No, he's on top of the dragon. He's grooming it.
So this mission is going well. Things are going well?
I think so.
Okay, I'm gonna start heading in your direction. I just want to make sure I can come pick up. Is there anything left? Is there more than 3 mechs?
I can't count out that.
Cool.
I am in one.
That's gonna look great on the reports. All right, yeah, no.
Thank you.
Yeah, the Academy's gonna be so happy they lost the full rent tech.
I'm okay.
Yeah, that's definitely what I asked first. I'm glad you're okay. I take your direction.
Thank you.
All right.
Send out some help.
That's my priority.
Is there any mishap? Okay, right? You still have a mishap active, right?
Yes.
So we just remove.
I would like that. Yeah.
Can remove your mishap.
I can fly.
Bringing us to Kiri. It's actually your turn now. So the hatch closes, and the first thing you realize is you're gonna have to pose to make this thing
how
work.
How do I lock into this thing? It's a pose, right?
I mean, you probably know how this works, and you've probably tried it occasionally.
I mean, we're besties.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
We flex in the mirror together all the time.
Okay, it kicks into gear. You still have 3 winged kobolds trying to.
Oh, should I?
Oh, please.
I am the big.
The strength and dex are switched because that's the modification. So. We talked about it.
Yes, and I paid attention.
That's the only difference.
Just these like in class.
Excellent.
Make a little note, maybe, because. Your brain might not remember.
The arrow's there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's on
there. There's you physical arrows. I can thrust into this thing.
Yes, you can.
Wait, you don't want me to do that, probably.
You can do whatever you want.
I'm thinking.
I can see a future where I'm just riding on top of everyone's
necks. I can self-destruct and kill the whole thing.
That was my plan before I found out about the wounds. That when I noticed the stat difference, I was like, I'm gonna fly in this thing's mouth. And then you're like, it's picking at something. I was like, okay.
All right, check this out. I'm gonna grapple it again.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right, cool. Yeah.
Plus,
you thought you got rid of me?
Not great.
You didn't.
Oh, wait, I guess you would roll again. 15?
13.
Oh.
Yeah! Come here, big boy. And I think that's all I can do.
Yep, that'll be your action.
All right.
You do have a bonus action that at some point you could use if you so desire later on. Dragon's gonna tail whip you. It worked pretty well last time. It's just gonna continue trying to do this.
Bonus action dodge.
Ooh.
Oh.
Can you dodge while grappled? I mean, it's.
You can.
Yeah.
You can't get me.
Look how flexible those wings are.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
We just saw that you can indeed do that. So that is a 19.
What is dodged?
It gives me disadvantage to hit you.
I think 19 misses.
19 misses because the armor class of that Rentek is 21, and it just is always 21.
Yeah.
So the tail, whoomp, your Rentek shakes, but nowhere near as much as yours used to. It's just kind of like a, oh, that's cool.
Maybe we should trade.
Sure. I mean, trade.
What are you trading?
Trade.
Rentek. Here, you can have shrapnel. I'll take your functional Rentek.
He built this one out of shrapnel.
Acid burning shrapnel heap at the bottom. It's yours, okay?
Slay. Like,
I feel like I'm getting the
no take back, Shelby. Yeah.
No, but I get the balls of it, though. It's only right. One Rentek. There's a lot of shrapnel.
Kai.
So I
have a functional Rentek.
Yeah.
The thing is good again.
Oh, wow. Well, system's online. Nice. Eke would like the sleeping. Kobolds to be no longer a thing.
Yes.
So I'm gonna pull out the sunfire bolts and.
Okay, you don't want to just wipe them out with a line that also. Okay.
Yeah, I thought about it, but I prefer my better judgment.
Last time someone tried that, it didn't go well for them.
Yeah. 22 and 20 to hit.
Ooh.
Okay, nice. We're doing okay here.
Yeah, all you needed was food.
That's all I needed.
A little burrito banter.
That's right. That is going to be 21 on the first hit.
Okay, that bolt explodes. Well, it just ceases existence, really. It just vaporized. A beam of energy, and it's just not there anymore.
Third kid on the second one. They're just like, do we ever have any kids?
So it's just, I don't remember. Hold your face, guys. And these little sleeping reptilians just cease existence.
Nice job, guys.
Message received.
For a second, there's a kobold. For another second, there's a giant beam of energy. And then a second later, there's nothing.
There's two shoes. To just roll
two little shoes. Smoking
shoes. It is
shoes,
an anime. There's smoky shoes.
Why was it wearing shoes? It's so weird.
Oh, no, they had culture and language. Oh, they can vote. Oh, no.
I like over to Putty and I was like, that's why we stay in the red tech.
Yeah. Right. Oh, no. We just get rid of kobold voters.
All right. We swing back up to Shogun. But before that, the dragon will attempt to tail whip its grappler again. And you're still dodging.
Yeah.
18, which is not going to be enough. So.
Lost it.
Oh. Thought off Shogun.
So you said I've made my way about halfway to this one. I'm going to use whatever movement I need to get on over there again.
So it'll be half your movement to get to the one side, because we're going to assume you're going at like half speed to like...
Okay, yeah.
He has a climb speed.
Yeah, but he's going at half speed because he's like...
In the air.
In the air attached to a dragon. Yeah.
Okay, cool. So whatever... I have 35 of... So whatever that...
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you can easily get to where you need to go.
Great. I'm going to do the same thing. Dinosaur. Do a little pull.
You have advantage on this because of the grapple.
Oh, that is a 14.
You might want to roll that again.
And that is a 23.
That'll do it.
That'll do it.
Again, just a...
Yeah.
This thing's got like it looks like a salad coming out of a burrito. It's just like all these green things sticking out of your.
This is so satisfying. It's like those videos you watch at night to go to bed.
I know exactly, right?
Like they start cleaning.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I love it.
Cutting the sponges and the little cubes, or the soap and the little cubes, and I'm like, what?
I can't hear you.
Like,
that is oddly addictive. I first watched it. I was like, what are they doing to the soap? And then I'm like, what are they?
So, why have I never done this to soap?
Yeah.
I could do this right now.
Yeah. I'm like, damn it, I have liquid soap.
Yeah. I've not experienced this.
You are wash these things and you
can we pause the episode?
The all of a sudden, on the screen, like, there's just overlays of the soap getting cut, and we're not watching D&D anymore.
Computer, bring up the soap. Great, so I tuck that away. Do I have enough movement speed left?
You can get to the last one.
To get to the last one? Okay, great.
That's what cost your action to remove.
And I'm going to try to do that.
Okay. Once again, you have advantage.
Light of hand.
Scheiße!
A 6 or a 9?
It looks like a 9 to me, plus 3, so that'd be 4.
You're probably going to do your advantage.
Oh, your shoes are awesome.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate
aren't they, though?
Oh, so just, cool.
Well, I feel like now we have to show the audience.
Oh, wow.
3D Converse.
Unlike those other Converse that just fade into a singular plane that you can't see.
aren't they called the 3D line?
I think they are. I was just being a goof. This is post-food me. I'm back, baby. Okay, so that's going to be 14 now. But I do have that advantage that you gave me that one time.
You can certainly spend reroll, yeah.
That is a nat 20 plus 4.
There we go.
That was my witness.
Nice.
Yeah, I feel like I have to like prove it when it is.
We'll believe you.
We know Bell's got
to for the amount of twos I'm getting, please. Keep going.
There we go.
I actually can't count that high, but I trust you.
So with having done this 3 times already, you've gotten pretty good at it.
Yeah.
So with just like a and this time,
it's just like shooting someone, but in reverse.
Yeah, exactly. It's just absolutely effortlessly. This is removed. The dragon once again like rears and roars, and then I will say, Takeda, you feel it kind of like the struggling kind of stop, sort of like adjusts.
I got it.
Can I see any more wounds?
No.
Amazing. And I'm all out of actions, or
yes.
Okay, great. Well, then I'm just gonna keep on holding on.
Yeah, you're out of pretty much. You have a bonus action if you want.
I am gonna go ahead and not use bonus actions right now. I'm gonna be just fine.
Okay.
Oh wait, actually, bonus action, I do have 2 weapon fighting. Is there anybody else that is... No, because I would have already had to use it.
Well, so here's what I'm gonna say. Okay. On doing that, theoretically the kobold's turn is next. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say the dragon actually like opens its jaw just with a quick like... And the kobolds sort of just stop whatever they're doing and kind of look at each other and...
we wanted to die terribly.
And they kind of start to pull back from the Rentek that they were surrounding as the dragon sort of kind of flexes as much as it can while still grappled. And it ceases hostilities.
Let's kill it! No, 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 no.
You really want to.
No.
It has let its guard down at this point. So for Eke, you would be up next. So you're kind of going to dictate where the rest of this goes.
So Eke will throw the glass away and sit up. And out of knowing Eke in his past have dealt with dragons, especially Thorantis, will lean up and I will cast Tongues on myself.
Mm-hmm.
Allowing me to speak and or understand any language. So I will say to it in its native tongue.
Are you broadcasting this through Rentek here to me?
Yeah, yeah. The speaker inside the mech will probably still pick up what I'm saying because it's like when you're standing outside the car of your door.
That's fair.
If you're on Bluetooth, they'll still hear you talk.
Yeah. That makes sense to me.
Mighty dragon, we have come to help you. Give us conversation. We will remove the poison from within you. He doesn't know he did that.
Yeah.
You're like,
but I'm hearing this and he can't hear me. So I'm just like, oh wait, no.
You're thaumaturgy, right?
Yeah, but
you could
amplify his noise.
Amplify your... The dragon. The dragon. The dragon will settle itself down upon the floating ground. Again, kind of flexing and rolling its shoulders.
Like it will just
kind of winces slightly as it does so.
Still being hugged, still.
Yes.
And let it go.
I must apologize. So,
the pain.
You can understand. It's speaking in common.
Oh, okay.
The pain so great. I knew not all but its embrace. I see the haze lift.
I get a little bit closer, just kind of reconvening with the party. Just gonna raise my hand and kind of wave over him, and there's just gonna be like this heroic wave of energy as I cast Mass Cure Wounds. And I'll just say, well, that's not a problem anymore.
Hands down all the skeletons. What's up?
Before I let you go, gonna be a good boy?
I find that incredibly reductive, given the circumstances. Yes.
You know what that word means? Where you are free to go.
hearing him say like the reductive thing, I like take the little dinosaur toy and I'm like.
Your companion has removed the pain that has racked my body. I am in debt to you.
Did he land at this point?
Like, yes, he has landed.
We all kind of were like,
Shogun's still on the dragon. Holy
but we can see it, right?
Now.
Yeah, yeah.
Shogun, did you touch the steel with your hands? Did you do it this? The mouth thing, in it goes, and let go.
There we go, yeah. No, I did that with the level.
Don't touch it.
I did cap it down like this, but I got my gloves, so.
Don't touch it.
Yeah, I figured it's glowing green. I'm a bit of a gamer. Sorry. Also, what is it? Also, why? Also, good job, me.
Yes, good job, you.
Thank
also,
you.
Because. Also, Renix Steel.
Oh. I know it. Tell me what it is.
Any of them know?
It's not. I mean, it is sort of part of the curriculum, but it's not really what the Luna Academy focuses on. They're all about the lunar.
I've never heard of these things before.
Well, Mike, you aced all your tests, so I feel like, oh yeah.
I know what you are. So, Val knows what you are.
I know what Eke knows based on previous shows.
You know what Eke knows.
Okay. Renix Steel is a form of arthritic alloy that destroys. Nullifies the use of mana. Steel used by an Ethereum army, a real force that tried to eradicate mana from the world. I'm afraid if this is affecting the dragon, and they're here in the islands, this mission has got a lot darker. That, and it is getting nighttime. Still,
Takiri, Eke, and Kai. The illusory symbols in your pilot section of the Rentec, everything goes red as you hear the magic mouth spell go off. Self-destruct.
Hey, yo! I didn't impress you, dumb robot.
So hold on. Do I know what that is?
Yeah, you know what that is.
We all know what the blinking red.
No. Sorry, I mean, like, do I know why that went off?
Okay. So, for the purposes of time, because this is going to happen very quickly, you get equivalent to a round to react to this.
Got it.
You hear this from their Rentex, but you personally are not in one.
Got it. And
you're sort of like, you're either still on the dragon or kind of like sliding down next to it. And
yeah, I'm just sort of nearby.
So I have the feet alertness. Would that not trigger anything?
I'm happy to give you a little more information there.
Okay.
The override has been pushed remotely.
Countdown in 10.
6.
What did you do?
Hello? Hello, is anybody there?
Okay, sorry. We got a round.
I do have a question. Explosion damage, is that a general, is it like fire type?
In this case, it'll be force. You're looking at a total of 180 force damage.
Got it.
From the collective total of, 60 per. So from the collective total, 180 force damage.
You also have a question.
Well, I wasted my healing, so.
It's okay.
You did well.
I take the dash action. Can I step of the wind?
You can't step of the wind the mech. Doesn't. You could like book it. You could get out of range.
I'm gonna dash, step of the wind, fly, and like I'm gonna pick my bro up and I'll fly with him.
That's what I was gonna do for you.
Hey, look, a bond of friendship.
I'm gonna get the fuck out of there and I'm just gonna come on, gotcha. Let's go.
You're being picked up.
Yes. Is it also my turn if I want to take an action?
You can certainly do something.
So I'm going to drop my... this is another concentration. So I'm going to drop my protection from acid. I'm going to summon Beast 90 feet away, close to Kai. Close to Kai, and it is this bee steel spirit has a flight speed of 60. So I would like it to pick up. Hopefully,
what form does it take?
What form does it take?
Is it pterodactyl?
Archaeopteryx.
Oh, okay. All right.
It's gotta be different.
Very good.
But yes. Gonna make sure that's.
Is that an Archaeopteryx?
How did you know?
What?
No, they're only like a kilogram. That's a pterodactyl. One.
Okay.
I just had to be different.
And it could be a pterodon.
It's a damn it! I was gonna say that.
A fucking pterodon?
You're so good at dinosaurs.
Yeah, that's the only thing I know.
I'm the autistic one here.
So a pterodon is conjured forth. In front of Kai, and you're fine because you're being carried off. So Kai,
it's what, and then we're jumping on and dashing on the pterodon.
All right.
So I guess Pud kind of like jumps on with you. They're definitely gonna say like, I don't know if we should leave the dragon. We worked so hard.
I know.
The dragon kind of looks down at what happened, looks at the rest of you,
run,
gives a nod, and is grabbing the Rentex and diving off.
Can they see they're here?
Just push them up the cliff. You don't have to dive.
That's what
them.
It's doing.
Oh my god.
I'll let you, obviously, you can do something, but the dragon looks like it's going to, like, move them away and, like, get them off.
Cool.
Pteranodon.
Do I think that I cannot reverse the Rentec of mine?
I don't know. Would you like to try?
Well, if I don't, I blow up.
That's right.
I did want it to sort of, like, swing by both of you all just in case, but, like, hopefully it's near. I don't know what your position.
There's the arm out. Okay.
So, take my hand.
Come on.
It's here.
Suspend.
Better not tell you now. So, in that case, so the reason why I asked this is because I knew that they were overridden by some other thing, and it is a mechanism that overrides.
Yeah, so the...
I know I can't reverse the whole darn thing.
The self-destruct sequence has been pushed remotely to your rent.
It's a button that I could reverse.
I mean, there is a button. That button was not pushed. The command was remotely sent.
This is magic based.
Yes.
If it's magic based, I can't reverse
it. It is magic based.
I cannot reverse it. Then in that case, I will Misty Step.
I was going to say, it's closer to...
It's a 30-foot thing away, so I will just go Misty Step up onto the back of the...
Pteranodon. It's different.
The Pteranodon?
Well, yes, thank you for...
Yeah.
Reach the hand out, Meke's like, yeah.
Okay. So as you sail off away from the explosion and the dragon like pushes the Rentex off, there is just this sort of bright white light of silence before this huge explosion emerges out. You're not sure if the dragon got away in time, but everything goes off. The shockwave slams against you, kind of knocking you around in the air. And as you settle on down on like another part of the archipelago, you can see that Lynn's ship is very quickly moving in the opposite direction away from
you. Hey, you left us on the thing!
Remember how a while back I always was half joking about how we should probably kill Flynn?
Why are we killing Flynn?
I think we've been betrayed.
Why does everyone hate us?
Sorbitiged. Again!
Sandobaged.
I agree. We've been bamboozled.
We've been schmickled.
Yes. Again.
We have each other.
You're still alive!
We all kind of forgot about that part of it.
We have each other.
You're never going to die.
I mean, I'll be the one to say it. Good on you for putting fun in your cockpit, because that might not have gone well otherwise.
I'm so glad, Kai, that you did that for sure.
I don't believe that Flynn willingly participated in what looks to be...
Really? Because they're about a mile and a half that way, so...
I would be willing to bet that Flynn is under some sort of...
Orders.
Orders, no. out of control. Oh. Killed me.
Mm.
Prison. How far is it away?
Oh.
120 feet?
More than that.
Watch this shit. Could I reach him?
They might shoot you, but if you can get me within 120 feet, I can find out.
The ship is moving at full boosted speed, and it is not carrying a bunch of Rentex, so it is just giving her.
Too fast.
Yeah.
Too fast, too furious.
As we've established, when the speed boost is on, it can keep pace.
You'll catch.
In fact, they are burning charges at a rate they really shouldn't be doing this far out from the lake. They're trying to get them. Very obvious.
One of us have a sniper.
Yeah, actually, just out of sheer curiosity, how many in the world feet would you say it's away?
You have sharpshooter?
No, but no, well, I'm not using shotgun. I'm using laser rifle, which we've coded.
Yes, it's
that's
so,
right.
With gunner or with the class that I've chosen, I get an extra 25 feet per shot.
I mean, I'm going to say it's probably like half a mile.
How much more to bet I could throw a putt over the...
However.
Yeah, ready.
However, I will give you, because I've always established your favorite terrain is mountain.
That's true.
And something seems a little off as kind of like taking in your surroundings, and you look over and you see that there's some shimmering in the air around the mountain, which you're now closer to because you moved further towards it. And you see little dots kind of making their way out of the mountain and coming closer.
Toward us?
Yes.
Are they of any particular color?
It's hard to say from this distance.
Spyglass.
Sharing all of this.
You see,
I'm like, I got a spyglass. Sorry.
You see, coming in at a reasonable pace, would appear to be some short-range flying vehicles. They look very strange. They don't seem to have mana crystals or any kind of Renica-type buoyancy. They're sort of like flushed with glowing green energy and like steam emanating out of the sides.
Are those?
And they look to be like single rider vehicles, which are flying towards where you are, and atop each of them is a humanoid figure in olive green armor.
Fellows, get to safety and hide now.
I'll take your word for it after that look on your face.
Fair enough.
Looking around, do we see anything around us that we could get?
Yeah, there's like rocky outcroppings and like that.
They look pretty tiny.
Just wait till
they grow really fast.
Being a parent is always so hard. Or I will become not a parent.
And I use my nature's fading in to become invisible.
Where'd you go? Nature's been... bro!
Is this magic?
Still here.
Oh.
It's just a bonus. Oh, it is magic. Yeah,
nature. They will find us.
Never mind. I'll do that.
What if I just grab...
Can you find us a rock outcropping?
Well, I'll find you one.
I mean, you can fly up, and I feel like Shogun can probably just...
Oh, I'll hold him up. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
All right, take a look, bud.
Also, I'm sorry, I'm looking for the thing that I have, because something is supposed to give me way more distance in my shot that I have here. Looking for.
Actually, you might be able to shoot these guys down from where we are.
That's
I'm thinking. There's only three of them, right?
It's four.
I'll be able to take
guys. Hold them up like
simple. I'm just trying to find, isn't it like a powder shot feature? Like where?
Your range is increased. That is definitely it.
Okay. So I can infuse shots into, like I can use magic to infuse.
Yeah, you can also shoot spells out of your gun.
That's what I'm, so I have fireball.
Yes, you do.
At a level three, I kind of want to cast.
That's 300 feet, I think, range, or is it 150 feet?
Let's see.
Here.
It's a good range.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to just look up fireball.
I mean, it's easy enough for you to kind of like take position and wait for them to get within range and then fire off. Like that's definitely an option.
It's 150 to 20, but my laser rifle can go anywhere from 100 to 300.
So you could shoot a fireball at 300 feet.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Which one of them I could hit that fireball 300 feet? And I shoot it right in the middle.
Do it for friendship.
Wait, for friendship, you say?
Yeah.
I sure am inspired by this.
Now, so are you just going to fire off at them from where you are, or are you going to, like, take cover and wait until... What exactly is the
plan? So we should find a place we can...
I'm going to say you've got seconds before they're on you. They're moving fast.
You can go for it, man.
I'm gonna press an Eldritch Blast if we don't have a plan.
Yeah,
just prepping. Like I'll start moving towards wherever Eke's going, but I'm ready for when they get in range.
I'm gonna just go ahead and. Oh, sorry.
No, I was gonna say, do I need to?
I don't think so. They're in the air. You're kind of on floating ground. So
I'm just gonna stand as I am and just be like, I never knew what my grandfather said to me. Fireball, bitch! And then I just shoot fireball.
Okay. At them. There's really nothing they can do about that.
That's awesome.
You're 300 feet away.
Sure.
So I'm gonna make some dexterity saves.
Great. That's awesome. 16, dude. By the way.
Yeah. I think the highest I got was a 14. Amazing. So
I guess I'll go ahead and roll those.
You can go ahead and roll those 8d6.
Plus four, which again also, does it just cast the spell through my bullets or does my bullet also hit them?
It casts the spell through.
Okay, great. So 86 plus four, we got.
Which they can't see the bullet.
Two.
Right?
One. God, three. Five, so that's eight. We are now at 11. That's half. 15, 21, 22, and 26 plus four, so that's 30 damage.
Hello?
There's a, so you just like a.
Yeah.
There's like a. And one of them just kind of spins out of control and crashes into the ground right next to you as the guy is like thrown off and smoking charred armor. The others just sort of explode and careen out of control in other directions.
Hope those were enemies.
Oh, wow.
Oh, they were.
Yeah, I'm sure they were.
Are they still flying or do they?
Oh, no, they've been. The vehicles don't have anybody to control them, so they're just like veering out of control and crashing.
Oh, the people just kind of plummeted to their deaths?
No, they exploded and died in their
shit.
Seat.
Now to interrogate them.
Eke just sits down.
Do you?
You talk to dead people, Kai?
Can you talk to Ash?
You can talk
they're
to
not, they're not Ash. They're just burnt husks of people.
Somebody kill me and see if I can talk.
Yeah.
No!
Let's do a pause for a second. Just, you know, let's take five just to gather ourselves, and then maybe we'll try that.
Take five bodies.
Well, look toward where they came from.
You see a mountain.
Where they came out of is nothing.
Mountain.
Go to this one.
Rock.
Oh, it's there. Yeah, one of the vehicles did.
Oh,
and like one. Crash
land. Okay.
Just be
nice.
Yeah, I'm gonna need 5 minutes or a short rest, if you will.
Okay.
Before
wait, don't. It. All of a sudden, you're like, I need 5 minutes. And you're. So I have an ability called Veil of Time. And in normal Amaria, Veil of Time, I'm allowed to take a short rest within a minute. Because we're doing the extended rules, that short rest happens in a round, and it's for everyone. So for one round, I basically just go, how much? Done. And you get your short rest.
That's all really weird.
So what I'll say is, for you guys, it still takes 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah. But
outside of where you are, it's instantaneous.
Yeah, I've got you in a pocket shell of time.
You are shunted into the veil for approximately 5 minutes, and then shunted back out.
I've been here before.
That's a good place.
I put on my mask, and then you watch as things start to change, but with the mask on, you can't really tell what happens to my face. And I just kind of put my hand over the corpse, just
awaken.
There is a glow of green energy that surges into the man, and his eyes and mouth and nostrils begin to flare up as it sort of just kind of glares at you lifelessly.
What did we?
I don't know.
God dang it, man.
Do you want to be our friend?
No.
No.
Everyone's down.
Oh, no.
Friend. Do not ask questions.
Why are you so shy when you can't spell?
You did that perfectly right. Well done, you. Do not ask questions. It has a limited use of power. We have blown 40% of it.
Can you hear us right now?
No.
Oh,
okay. Not for the next 40 seconds. Now, what are we going to ask? That would have been 2 more questions. Had I not have blown this power now?
Honestly, you might as well sort of leave us here as you guys talk, but I'm just going to go ahead.
One way to do that.
Friendship kiss?
Yeah. Like,
so, yeah. Hey, it's an anime. You guys can make it all over the questions. That's fine.
Bro kissing. For justice.
That's what I call it. Yeah, we on ice.
That is so good. Waiting for the Yahweh founder.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, it's coming.
Okay. And I can just watch us.
Oh, are we?
Oh, we'll have to actually kiss.
Yes. Yeah, we are.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so the characters are making out.
Yes.
So while they're making out, camera pans down. Flaming face.
Yeah.
We have. I was going to say, what a character. I was going to say we have 3, right?
You could take lead on this.
A bit like a Who's Line sketch, where it's like, who can say stuff without doing a question? Yeah.
Flank his kiss.
You play it safe.
How do you think Wayne Brady and Colin Mockery got through those?
That's right. Yeah.
Brian Stellars would never guess.
Tell me what this corpse looks like. What are they wearing?
So this is it's still kind of hard to tell because they're full armor still. They had like a full helm and everything, but you can see their eyes glowing green, with as they're sort of given a facsimile of life, but they are dressed in olive green armor. They had what appears to have been some kind of like sash on, but it's been like burnt and roasted, and you can't really make out on it. And they have a long sword hilted at their side, but their armor is very like it's done not in a stylistic medieval way. It kind of has a little bit more of a modern-esque styling to it. Like it looks more like modern like body armor than like medieval armor. Like it's sort of like an advanced type of equipment. And as you kind of examine them a little bit more, you see that at first what you thought was a longsword is actually just a hilt.
Interesting.
At their side, there doesn't appear to be anywhere that like a blade is going. It's just a longsword hilt on their side, and they do also seem to have like some sort of mechanical gear, like respiratory stuff on them, likely for high elf on them as well.
One.
Oh, did you cast
Not kiss.
He's like, oh, did you? And he just puts it up. He jumps up and says,
Platonic.
We both consented to this.
Okay. What are the Weed Breakers doing in Lunalia?
Building weapons.
As I grab a hilt off of his.
It doesn't feel great.
Yeah, for sure.
It doesn't feel great.
I expected that.
It's like,
That goes
tingly, uncomfortable. Yeah, it's not feel great.
Okay, kind of goes in between, kind of like takes the suction point out, grabs you. We go into a huddle very quietly and a distance away so they can't hear. Consider it at some point. I am like five. Focus. So, what's another good question to ask? They're Weed Breakers. Do you know who they are?
And we do, so that you don't have to give us extra info from them as a quick and tell us later.
What?
I don't know. It's been a weird day.
Yeah.
Should ask the size of their.
If they were responsible.
Pretend it was an Imperial enemy. Eradicate. And they are building from a faraway land. They have come here to infiltrate and build weapons.
Moon people.
No.
You like me? Yes or no?
That's not a good question.
Yeah. What's the size of my operation?
War operation?
Punches in the middle.
So, Eke just like sees this and goes. And he goes and he reaches up and he touches your. As you tore each other, you may continue.
I was like, what did you expect differently from this?
And he turns back and as they're kissing behind him, just like, kids. And then he walks over. To whom? Which organizations you allied yourself with here? And or people? Come on.
Oh, I know what.
Yeah, I understand.
Neo Empire, the Presence, and the Infiltrators at Loon Academy.
I'm willing to bet those guys are Infiltrators. I turn around, huddle.
Yeah, you have one left.
More questions?
One more question left. Yeah, you're in two.
Oh yeah, Pud's on the ground.
Yeah, Pud's in the middle looking up being like, what?
Oh, also, is there, above game, does anybody have the, sort of like, inbound thing so we can sort of take a, like, this roof of-
I do not,
but damn.
Your Rentex did.
Thanks, Devin. Thanks, Devin. That's a great idea. What would have been in that one?
I'm really good at impressions.
What we need is a recording stone, right?
Yeah.
Sensory stone.
How much do they cost?
A lot.
We could always find a mage to pull memories later.
I'll remember this. Happened.
How much are sensory?
I mean. I'm gonna tell you right now, they record things that happen, not like previously.
Yeah.
Oh, we got one more question to ask.
Well, what I was gonna say is, there is magic that lets you like read the past of people. Like that.
Time that does that.
That's right.
Okay.
I just want to cover our bases here.
Does he have eyes?
Yes.
They're glowing.
Yeah, they're glowing.
I can get one more thing out of him before we ask the last question.
That is hard.
Hold on. We want to know if I could see any moment of this person's previous life. What would we like to see?
Do they like us?
I'm gonna go ahead and have a moratorium on Pud talking just for a minute.
I'll close my dragon mouth.
Well, see his big boss is.
Can you take back
if we can find out the layout of their base, maybe?
Yeah, or like that. Yeah, layout of the base, yeah.
Layout of the base or people of interest?
I think people of interest too, because at least then we know what we're working with.
I get like a 2 minute stint of their life. So
check
who
their Depeche Mode is.
Yeah.
I'm going to go back to it.
I think so.
Before I ask you the last question, you guys just see like a moment in time, but when I spin and like cause of time, I'm going into this person's previous past with the intention of seeing them at a meeting where they're learning the information that they've been telling us. And okay. I want to take note of who they see.
What are you specifically looking for?
I'm looking for them sitting at a table, at a meeting, and sifting through their mind to try and find a point on which they're superiors, if they aren't the superiors. Mm-hmm.
But these are not the superiors.
And or...
Yeah, we just won the campaign.
Yeah.
And or the people...
Good job, team.
Right? Go team. Thanks for watching, everyone. Bye. And or the people that don't belong with the Weavebreakers that would be communicating with them. Members of the Presence... More so the infiltrators. Who are the infiltrators and stuff?
Okay, so what you get then is you see that there is, you see this the same individual in an airy where there are winged creatures and they are scribing missives, attaching them to wings that are being blown off, and then other animals are coming in and they are reading, and what you're seeing is coded in some way. You can't read.
I still have tongues going.
I let you speak. It doesn't let you read. It's definitely, there's like definitely ciphers and codes involved and kind of rolling that up. And they're doing very analog style communication. What you do recognize is that the parchment being sent and ink and dial is very similar to things you would find in like the library of Loot Academy. You also, is this like one specific instance, or do you get like kind of a montage of things?
No, it's one scene. Like if they're sitting at a dinner with a bunch of the villains and they're having a conversation about how they're going to take over the world, that's the scene I want to see. But I can only see that scene.
Okay,
I can't see them making out afterward or whatever happens.
What you will see then is sort of shadowy. It's very foggy, maybe not fully complete memory. It seems like it's more constructed about things that have been witnessed, not necessarily in person, but like imagined and seen. It's still a memory, but not of something that necessarily they saw with their own eyes. But what you do see is a table with various figures in armor and other types of things sitting around this table, each of them inscribed clearly in this vision with a number going from 1 to 10. And you see like different things, like you see 10 is decked out in this weird sort of apparatus, and you can see like, you can hear like a wheezing kind of breathing, mechanical breathing sound. You can see 9, just this massive hulk of a person just kind of like resting down on the table. You see 2 other figures who are sort of just like in interesting poses. You can see that there is an old man and make out a glowing eye, kind of ponders and strokes a beard. You see a guy just sipping at tea, leaning back in his chair with a big rice hat and a elf as he sips the tea and just kind of sets it down and throws it away. And then you can see there is a figure who is wreathed in chains of green metal that glow dimly in this shadow as he just sort of gestures towards a map where you can see Loon Academy with a pin and other islands of Lunalia that are marked all above the southern of Thalagrant. And you can see that the mountain region that you saw has it kind of dictated as sort of like home location. And there are various arrows kind of pointing out in different directions. And then as he lowers his fist, the on the map basically just like crosses out all those islands and then crosses out the entire empire of southern Thalagrant and go back in again.
Useful.
Sure.
What about male models? No.
The best improvised line of all time.
Like you see, your master Roshi is basically like, he's pretty calm most of the time, and he's not worried. You actually see his ears flop even lower, and he just goes, "Oh,
any operation?
This is big. One last question, then.
Of course.
Where is your command?"
Mountain base.
Yeah.
Right here. Perfect.
How convenient. And I turn, and I will, so Eke turns, and he will just kind of like in his own tongue explain everything in detail. But the details that he adds to it is are the following things. They are going to try and drain the mana that holds up these islands in an attempt to cause a catastrophe. Big islands falling. You would know it happened to your people many, yes, many years ago. No. Mana, no.
Oh.
They are going to attempt to cause these islands to fall to the surface below and eradicate more of mana in Aria.
And on that reveal, we'll have to wait next time.